Hello, my name is Yelena Timanova and I am a tour guide at the Museum of Russian Lubok and Naive Art. I want to introduce you to the world of Naive Art and walk you through our exhibition, The Art of the Brave, Naive. What is Naive Art? Those are the works of self-taught artists who don't have a systematic understanding of the technique of drawing and the theory of art. The Naive artists are driven by a need for creation and not by a desire for fame or wealth. Their road is difficult and thorny. Despite being mocked and misunderstood by others, they continue to create. And this speaks of their courage. Courage helps them to create in spite of their lack of knowledge of anatomy and perspective. It helps them not only to draw on canvases, but it guides them to the point where they are able to express their innermost thoughts on a chip of fiber board found in the trash. In our exhibition, there are four blocks about courage that will acquaint you with the classics of Russian Naive and their stories. Our first section is called Courage to Be Yourself. It formed mostly by self-portraits, revealing the importance of personal growth and the problems of self-awareness. The first author I want to tell you about is Alexander Pavlovich Labanov. He was born in 1924. As a child, he had meningitis, which made him deaf. He studied at a specialized boarding school for deaf and mute. When his father died, he was sent to a psychiatric hospital. And when his mother left this world, his relatives stopped visiting him at the hospital, sincerely assuming that he was dead. But he was alive and worked tirelessly on his paintings. Weapons often can be found in his works, especially the Mosin Nagant. Taking a real model of a weapon for a basis, his fantasy modified it. Weapons appeared in his work for a reason. During the war years, soldiers jokingly promised to give him a rifle, and he carried his dreams about it throughout his whole life, finding their realization in creativity. For example, in this painting, we can see Alexander Pavlovich stands on the fence of his country with a rifle in his hands. With weapons and heraldic signs, one might think that this is not a self-portrait of a man locked in four walls, but a portrait of a military hero. Perhaps this is how he saw himself in his imagination, as someone strong and brave, and his imagination helped him to create thousands of paintings. During his lifetime, he stayed in the hospital until his death in 2003. And here we can see paintings by Vladimir Anosov. He was born in Altai in 1953, but he moved to Moscow in 1976. He started painting in 1992. His career began with his dream. He had a dream to hang a copy of famous painting by Viktor Vasnetsov, Ivan Vasilievich, on a gray wolf at his home. But this copy was too expensive for him, so he decided that he will create his own. So he take paint and brushes in his hands for the first time, and while he was copying someone else's work, he discovered a talent of an artist in himself. This is a portrait of his mother, but also there we can see words of affection for his such a dear but so distant home region of Altai. Take a look at his technique. This is look more like a poster than a painting in a traditional way. Back in the day, when his artistic career just started, he was working as a trolley bus driver, and this is a tribute to his driver's working day, where workers are accompanied by an angel. this is his self-portrait where he decided to depict himself next to a beer. We can assume that his ancestry and his past career forged him into the artist he is today. Igor Florianovich Zakharov. He was born in 1934. Ever since he was a little boy, he dreamed of traveling. He studied to be an engineer and served on a submarine for several years. But later he decided to change his profession and enrolled to a medical university. He worked as a doctor for 15 years. His life path can be traced in this painting, which is called Living Life is Not a Field to Cross. And this painting tells us about his past careers and his hobbies. So we can say that he was a smoker. He liked Dostoevsky, Dame specifically, and he listened to Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. It is also worth noting the perspective of his work. His paintings look more like frames from the movies. So by looking at his paintings, we can scroll through the frames of his life. Our next section is called Courage to be a Woman. And this section is presented by paintings that opens a woman's view of the world. For a long time, professional painting has been a male territory, but non-professional painting has given many women the opportunity to express themselves and make a name for themselves. Perhaps this is the reason why there are so many female names in the naive art. I want to introduce you to the works of Anait Kikinyan. An Armenian painter, she lived in a patriarchal world, and she showed us this world in her works, so we can see the bright colors in the scenes of life in a village in her native Armenia. In this world, women are expected to do household chores. As we can see at this painting, she is preparing a meal and she is being supervised by an older relative at the same time. In this circumstance, being a painter for a woman is a great courage. So this speaks of her bravery. Anait lived near the town of Spitak, which was destroyed by an earthquake in 1988. Fortunately, she survived this tragedy, but she gave up on painting. Stefania Basilenko. She was born in 1919 in Vitebsk. She knew German very well and she worked as a translator during the war. Later, she taught at the Moscow State University. She started painting in 1979. And this is her self-portrait where she shows herself in her youth. Most naive artists who prefer smaller sizes in their canvases, her works are big and monolithic, and she has paintings on various topics, including military topics, but in our exhibition we want to show you her paintings about women. These paintings glorify the beauty of Russian women, as the name Russian and Russian Madonna suggest. Take a look at this painting. See how the woman in Russian is illuminated by the light. Does it descend on her or does she radiate it? We can only guess about it. Stefania Ivanovna Bazilenka lived a very long and interesting life, and she died in 2010. This is the painting by Lyudmila Voronova, or Lucia Voronova as she called herself. In 1978, she graduated from the art faculty of the Moscow University of Technology. And her thesis was in tapestry. Now, this painting may seem naive to you, but we cannot count Lyudmila among the naive artists, since she has an art degree. Such artists are called primitivists. Next section of our exhibition is called Courage to Fight No Matter What. This section is formed by the works of two artists who represent two types of struggle, fighting in a real military battle and fighting oneself. The first artist is Alexander Belich. He was born in 1948. And he started painting in the late 1980s. At the beginning of his career, his paintings were not so large. But in his later years, in the last years of his life, he decided to create a cycle of works, a large works on historical subjects. This triptych, called Militar of Minin and Pozharsky, tell us about the events that took place in 17th century. And in 1612, People's Militar, led by Kuzma Minin and Dmitry Pozharsky, were able to liberate Moscow from the Polish invaders. This was an example of solidarity of the entire nation, where people of different social statuses and religion were united as one in the battle. And this painting is dedicated to the siege of Kazan. This work tells us about the events that took place in the 16th century, when in order to straighten the eastern borders and expand the territory of the Tsardom of Russia, Ivan the Terrible organized a campaign of conquest, as a result of which the Kazan Khanate fell as an independent state and became a part of the Tsardom of Russia. Vasily Ivanovich Shevchenko. He was born in 1926. During the Great Patriotic War in 1945, he was seriously injured. After the war, he spent several years in hospitals, from where he came out with a disability. The horrors of war imprinted in his mind, which later was reflected in his work. He started painting from going out to nature, where he created thousands of sketches. Constantly trying new approaches and techniques. Sometimes he would put the brushes aside and start mix the paint with his own fingers to achieve the color he wanted. Shevchenko's name gained popularity abroad earlier than in his home country. While in other countries his talent was praised, at home, his works were misunderstood and were considered anti-Soviet and even removed from the exhibitions. But later, citizens of his own country started to notice his talent and his unique view of the world. In the last 20 years of his life, he received success, recognition, and a muse which he found in his wife. Vasily Ivanovich Shevchenko left a huge legacy with thousands of paintings, and he died in 1997. Pavel Leonov. He was born in 1920, and he lived a long and difficult life, which included a childhood with a tyrannical father, several years in prison, and in some point in his life, famine. In 1980s, in order to earn some money, he offered his paintings to his local museum. But his works were misunderstood, and this rejection was really hard on him. He decided to give up on painting and nailed his paintings on the walls in his closet. But in the 1990s, a well-deserved success, along with numerous orders, came to him, which helped him to spend the last years of his life without worrying about money. When we look at his paintings, it strikes both in size. All of his works are big. But also in his approach, fill the space. Look, his paintings are divided into different parts where at the different screens, different actions take place. Pavel Leonov left great artistic legacy, and we are glad to show you part of it. Vasily Dmitriev. He started cutting his first sculptures out of wood in the 1970s. The shape of a piece of wood or root would suggest him the idea for the future sculpture. He was not afraid to combine wood with any materials he had at hand. We can say that the whole world was his palette. Look how many representatives of the animal kingdom came to our exhibition. Екатерина Ивановна Медведева. She started to paint at the age of 39, and success came to her almost right away. The artist calls herself Katya, as if emphasizing the fact that, despite her real age, she will continue to look at the world with a pure and childish look. Katya's work was appreciated not only by the audience, but also by the acknowledged masters. German journalist and actor Norbert Kuhnke showed Katya's works to Marc Chagall. The master was really impressed with her work with color, and he handed her an autographed album. In her later years, Katya decided that she got tired of city life and moved to the countryside, but she continued to create. In her years, she had a chance not only to try herself as a painter, but Elsa to walk in front of the camera. She starred in a movie in the role of herself. Religious subjects take a special place in her works, and her paintings on this subject adorn the walls not only in the exhibition halls, but also in churches. This painting is called Christmas, and it's made with acrylic paint on chiffon. And finally, I want to tell you about this carpet embroidered by Ksenia Nazarovna Karagot. This carpet was created during the horrible time of World War II. For 3 years, from 1940 to 1943, Ksenia Nazarovna worked on this masterpiece. Completed with the love for her daughters, this carpet served as a portal from the horrors of real world to the fairy tale one. One might think that such a valuable piece should never leave the walls of its home, but life decided otherwise. Ksenia's grandson was in need of money, so he had to put it up for sale. Art collector Anna Kiva was able to fundraise enough money to purchase the carpet, and she gave it to us, to our museum, with the condition that it will always be on the display. And that condition gave the beginning of our permanent exhibition, which I presented to you today. In the conclusion, I would like to say that I saw our artists come from different segments of the population and the cities. I think that they are united by the courage to dream. Dream of living in a society where they are accepted and understood. Dream of a life where they can devote themselves to art instead of going to the job they don't like in order to provide for themselves and their families. Their dreams have come true. And I would like to wish you the courage to dream and your dreams to come true. Thank you for joining me today.